What's your breaking point? Is it the guy who cuts you off in traffic? Or maybe your boss talking down to you? I've reached my breaking point thanks to those smelly, loud, obnoxious, rude, anti-shower, Wall Street-hating, bank-bashing, pro-protesting, campground-loving, Occupy losers. I'm tired of talking about them and I'm tired of hearing about them. I'm just so annoyed. Will they ever give up? Please say yes. Please say yes. New York City finally came to its senses and evicted squatters from a park near Wall Street. When will Baltimore get the courage to throw the bums out of McKeldin Square? Mayor Rawlings Blake?
There's no deadline.
Just curious. Since the city is allowing Occupy losers to break the law and camp out downtown, I'd like to know what rules I can break in the city. Did you hear about the proposed Ripley's Museum at Harbor Place? They want to put a three-dimensional green sea monster on the front of the building. But the city asked them to tone down the design so it doesn't overpower the harbor. What about the Occupy campground? Don't you think that overpowers me? I can deal with a big green monster. I have a personal message for the Occupy punks. I understand you want change, but don't be a hater. Work on yourself first. Shower, shave, put on some fresh clothes. Get a job, go to school, adjust your attitude, stop being so annoying. Do that. Then we can talk about your demands and I can laugh and laugh and laugh. I'm spent. Mayor Rawlings Blake, with great power comes great responsibility. I'm begging you, evict them, please. I'm just saying. I'm Josh Spiegel for Maryland's News Now. Where will you be when the world ends in August? Oh, you haven't heard? The world is ending August 2nd. Something about a debt ceiling and defaulting and Social Security and all of us dying. Everyone's angry and frustrated. The president even walked out of talks with Republicans. Can you blame him? It's not easy putting a budget together. I mean, you probably do your own budget. Okay, now multiply your budget by a gazillion. Personally, I am in favor of limited budget cuts, but my idea is kind of controversial. Yeah, I think the TSA should be abolished. We need some sort of upgrade. An upgrade that involves common sense and better uniforms. I have to include the following statement. Not all TSA agents are bad, and most TSA agents work hard. There are plenty of agents that have seized dangerous weapons from dangerous people, like a toy from a mentally challenged man and a diet peach Snapple from me. It's just that a Nigerian man with a penchant for false ID managed to slip past security at JFK in New York. That's New York City, the terrorist attack capital of the United States. And the other day, a stun gun mysteriously ended up on a JetBlue flight that landed in Newark. Don't worry. If the TSA is abolished, agents won't lose their jobs. They'll be reassigned to screen children entering preschools. They'll also be needed at the entrances to nursing homes to screen 95-year-old women with dirty diapers. In the end, it all works out. I'm just saying. I am Josh Spiegel on the Afternoon News Journal.